My grand Dhamma father, Sehateji, was also a cultivator, but he turned into a Dhamma cultivator. He started sowing seeds of Dhamma. Sehaji Ubakhin came here for 7 times to meditate. In those days, meditation was done here. Sehaji Ubakhin will also come here. Other students will come here. And Sehataji will sit there. From there, he will give metta, give strength to the meditators. Although in the attire of a family man, a lay person, inside he lived the life of a monk. So very much pure was his life that people will keep on getting inspiration by his life. Therefore, we express our feeling of infinite gratitude towards Sehataji. This is the sacred land where Sehaji Ubakhin got his second birth, coming out of the shell of ignorance under the guidance of Sehataji.
In 1937, Ubakhin crossed the Yangon River on the way to Sehataji's village to take his first meditation course. From there onwards, there was no looking back.
My Dhamma father, Sehaji Ubakhin, used to say that the time clock of Vipassana has struck. Now it must go to its country of origin, India, and from there it will spread. No one can stop that progress.
Ubakhin combined his profound dedication to Dhamma with his devotion to government service throughout his life. He was one of the most distinguished civil servants of his time in Myanmar. On the day the country gained independence, he became the accountant general, and for the next 2 decades he also served in a variety of government posts, sometimes holding several of them simultaneously. His efficiency and integrity were unsurpassed. But serving his country on the mundane level was not enough. He was eager to share the jewel of Vipassana and help people find the path to liberation. In 1952, he established the International Meditation Center in Yangon, where he started teaching Vipassana meditation. As a teacher, Ubakhin insisted on strict discipline, but at the same time, he showed immeasurable love and compassion. He was able to explain Dhamma in a way that Buddhists and non-Buddhists alike could grasp and appreciate. His unique non-sectarian interpretation of Dhamma and his ability to teach in English drew people from different countries and religious backgrounds. Sehaji Ubakhin paved the way for Dhamma to start spreading all over the world, far beyond the borders of Myanmar. In 1955, S.N. Goenka, a successful businessman and the leader of the Indian community in Burma, took his first Vipassana course with Sehaji Ubakhin. It was a life-transforming experience. He continued to study for 14 years under the guidance of Sehaji and became one of his foremost students.
We remember this brilliant shining star in the galaxy of Dhamma, Sehaji Ubakhin, my Dhamma father. He had so much love and compassion for the entire suffering humanity, but special love and compassion for India. He kept on saying that I have to pay back the debt of gratitude. This wonderful, invaluable Dhamma came from India, and today India is bankrupt. They don't have Dhamma. He very much wanted to go himself to give Dhamma, but due to certain reasons he could not go. And a situation arose due to which, even as a Burmese citizen, I got a passport to go to India. He was so happy, so pleased. Now you will go as my representative and you will fulfill my mission, my vision. I had my own hesitation because I knew my limitation. But he encouraged, saying that you have nothing to worry because Dhamma is going there. And through you, I am going there and you will be successful. You need not worry. It was all the power of Syaji Obakhin. It was all the blessing of Syaji Obakhin that within 1 month, the first course of 10 days was given in India. And then after that, the Ganges of Dhamma started flowing throughout the country, courses after courses, courses after courses. Unbelievable. And hundreds of people, thousands of people from around the world, they started coming to India. And they started taking these courses. Unbelievable. It made me feel all the more that I am just a representative of Syaji. I am just a representative of Syaji. Everything is done by Dhamma, everything is done by Syaji Obakhin. Therefore, on this day, when we are all assembled here to pay our homage to this great householder saint, Syaji Obakhin, our Dhamma father, the only way to pay real respect to Syaji Obakhin is live the life of pure Dhamma. Be a good example of somebody living the life of pure Dhamma and keep on serving people egolessly, always thinking that I am the representative of Syaji Obakhin. May the Dhamma vision, may the Dhamma mission of that great teacher Syaji Obakhin get fulfilled. May more and more people around the world get benefited by this wonderful Dhamma. May all come out of their suffering. May all be happy, be peaceful, be liberated.